Hi and welcome to this edition of Out of the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is a TP-Link Omada Wireless 7 access point. This is the EAP723. This is a BE3600. Now you probably start to see some of these numbers around. BE stands for Wireless 7. 3600 stands for the amount of megabits a second in total it can do. That means it probably does about just over 600 megasecond in the 2.4 gigahertz frequency. And in this instance, in the 5 gigahertz, the difference is made up there. So we've got almost, again, 3 gigabits a second of speed. This is not a big technical overview. We've got plenty more of those, deep dives, speed analysis, and those type of things on our YouTube. This is to show you what you get in the box. So let's head on in and see what we get here. So you're going to get your quick started guide, how to set this up. Just do notice here, there is no PoE injector. This is a PoE powered device. Please do make sure you've got a PoE switch or you get the appropriate PoE injector for it. So you're gonna get your installation guide. You're gonna get a little conformity guide for the region you're in. Probably again, won't have a look at that. You're gonna get quite a lot of screws and lugs and fittings. So let's go through really how this works. This is our universal mount. So what's the idea? We're gonna screw that up into our hard surface, for instance, or our ceiling like this. And then onto the bottom of this, we can twist and lock this into place, all right? And that is then held like that. Now, what if we actually had a false ceiling, a suspended ceiling? Well, what we can actually use is this packet. We've got these little metal washers. So each one of these is gonna be four of those, is gonna go on the other side of our ceiling tile. And if you like, they're going to be between there, and our ceiling tile is going to be sandwiched between the two. We've got some bolts and nuts in there. Those are going to hold that in place. And so you've just made four small holes through. You've made a little hole through your ceiling tile for your Ethernet cable to come down. This is bolted up, and these plates pull it down into place and hold it, sandwich the tile. And then again, you're going to bring the access point up and click it into place. So that's our universal mount. For false ceilings, suspended ceilings, and for hard surfaces. Gonna get our screws and to be able to put that onto the suspended ceiling. We're gonna get some plugs and screws for hard mounting. We're gonna get some other different screw options for holding this all in place securely. And then you're gonna get the device itself. So like I said, this is a Wireless 7. It's got a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port on here. It's a PoE powered device. It needs at least PoE plus to run. You'll see we have the option also for a 12 volt power pack. You can buy those optionally extra if you don't want to do PoE. And you've got our reset on this side. This, like I said, is a Wireless 7 device. It runs just in the 2.4 and the 5 gigahertz frequency. We've got a 2x2 radio in both of those frequencies. As you can see, really nice small form factor. And in a moment, I'll just bring it up so you can see how small this is. But if you're looking for a good starting point for Wireless 7, this could be an option. Do remember, you do need a controller, either the software installed locally, one of the hardware controllers, or the cloud set up for TP-Link Omada to make the best use of this. So let me just hold this up so you can actually see how small that is. Really neat and discreet to be able to mount that on a wall or a ceiling. So hopefully that's been useful. That's the TP-Link EAP723 Wireless 7 access point. We've got plenty more updates and videos on wireless and camera firewall security over on our YouTube channel. Plenty of how-to guides. What do I need to run TP-Link Omada? How do I set up TP-Link Omada? So why don't you head over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.